Okay, today I'm going to go over a hollow hold variation for improving overhead mobility. So the hollow hold and core stability is huge for overhead positioning. So if you're not stable through your core and you're trying to lift overhead and you can't maintain this core bracing the ribs down, then you're going to have a shoulder joint that's on an unstable foundation. So the importance of keeping good rib position, good ab engagement, while being in an overhead position is huge, and I'm going to show you guys a movement here today that's going to challenge that and really challenge your core stability while improving some thoracic and overhead mobility. So lying on your back, you're going to grab a light kettlebell, much lighter than you think. This is pretty tough at 8 kilograms, and if you have something smaller, if you don't have a kettlebell that's light enough, then you could even use like a 5 pound plate or 10 pound plate or something, but you're gonna hold it sideways with the bottom up, cupping around the bell, and then you're gonna lie on your back, gonna press the weight straight overhead. Legs will start straight up, and then you're gonna drop into this hollow position. So creating tension, keeping a nice neutral position. Don't wanna see as the legs straight, don't want to see them start to bend or the back arch up. So key with this is to keep that back against the floor. And if you're in that proper hollow position, you want to keep that back against the floor. You should feel those abs really kicking in. So once you get into that position, then you're going to squeeze the kettlebell and just raise it overhead until you feel your ribs start to flare up. So you'll hit a point where you feel like you can't go any further, or the ribs will start, you'll start to arch there, and that's your stopping point. Keep that hollow position and pull it back to the start. So retighten, make sure the back's flat, squeeze the bell, pull overhead, pause, and come back up and lower down. So you'll figure out, sometimes 1 to 2 reps of this is more than enough. You're gonna find this challenges the abs big time. You have to really fight to avoid arching too much through the back, and then keeping that good hollow position as you go overhead. And sorry, this fly is swarming around me. But so keep that position, and then really fight, keep the abs tensed in, and then you're controlling the shoulders with that overhead position. This is going to translate a lot to any of your overhead movements. You're pulling, you're pushing, and maintaining a good position while you stabilize. So give this a try. Let me know what you guys think, if there's any questions.